Greetings. This video is part 8 in a series debunking and refuting every claim Islam makes to insert Mohammed into God's Word. Deuteronomy 18:18, Song of Songs 5:16, Isaiah 29:12, Deuteronomy 33:2, and now Isaiah 42:13. The Lord will go forth like a warrior. He will arouse his zeal like a man of war. He will utter a shout, yes, he will raise a war cry. He will prevail against his enemies. This is another verse that Islam and its teachers try to claim as a reference to Muhammad. Oh, dear Jesus! This is another prophecy about your Father, about Almighty God. The Lord will go forth like a warrior. He will arouse his zeal like a man of war. He will utter a shout, yes, he will raise a war cry. He will prevail against his enemies. What about this verse can Islam even dare to think foretells of an unlearned man? He will utter a shout, yes, he will raise a war cry. More pronouns. More diversions. Years ago, I often debated Mohammedans who claimed Mohammed was not a warrior. That kind of flies in the face of Islam trying to use this verse as mention of Muhammad. Forget for a moment who this verse actually talks about. The Lord God Yahweh will go forth like a warrior. The Lord God Yahweh will arouse his zeal like a man of war. The Lord God Yahweh will utter a shout. Yes, the Lord God Yahweh will raise a war cry. The Lord God Yahweh will prevail against his enemies. Forget that. Forget God. Forget Prophet Isaiah. Let's just toss that out and drink the Kool-Aid. Isaiah is going to mention someone 6 times in Isaiah 42:13. The first mention is clearly the Lord, Yahweh. But according to Islam, God is only the warm-up act for Muhammad. Isaiah only makes you think he's talking about God. But the secret is out. Isaiah is really a prophet of Muhammad. Whenever Isaiah says he, that's only code for Muhammad. Just toss out proper usage of language, grammar, and reading. Pronouns to represent a proper noun? And one that just occurred? Whatever you do, don't read it like this. The Lord God Yahweh will go forth like a warrior. The Lord God Yahweh will arouse his zeal like a man of war. The Lord God Yahweh will utter a shout, yes. The Lord God Yahweh will raise a war cry. The Lord God Yahweh will prevail against his enemies. Islam knows it must mean this. The Lord God Yahweh will go forth like a warrior. Muhammad will arouse his zeal like a man of war. Muhammad will utter a shout. Yes, Muhammad will raise a war cry. Muhammad will prevail against his enemies. But that's enough Kool-Aid for now. Like every desperate claim Islam makes to invent a way to insert Muhammad into God's word, the rape of Isaiah 42:13 by Islam's falsehoods can be refuted based on many logical flows. You will find it does not contain the word prophet, nor healer, nor teacher. In fact, it says warrior and man of war. So you cannot claim this is Muhammad and deny he was a warlord who fought and killed people. You will find it does not speak of the education of this individual mentioned. Isaiah 42:13 does not meet the description of Surah 7, 157 and 158 of the unlearned prophet. Isaiah 42:13 does not mention this he being unable to read and write. And yet the Quran claims that you can find that description in the Torah and Bible. Isaiah is not even in the Torah, meaning the law which Moses delivered to Israel. And as I proved in the previous video, Isaiah is not one of the 25 prophets of Islam that Allah could remember to include in the Quran. Islam literally does not know what to do with Isaiah. They need him badly because of their desperate situation. If Islam cannot find mention of Mohammed, his claims were lies. But the worst and most damning problem for Islam with Isaiah 42:13 is that this verse clearly speaks of Almighty God. And that is damning for Islam because they do not care who they twist to fit Mohammed. Islam will smash God and twist God to make God fit Mohammed. For a religion that claims to respect the God of the prophets, the God of Prophet Isaiah, the God of Moses, Islam makes that impossible to believe. It is easier to believe Muhammad is the Allah of Islam, and his followers will do anything to give him credentials. And the blasphemy of twisting prophecy of God to fit Muhammad, every Muslim on earth should be ashamed of Islam that this is taught. There is no easy or gentle way to say it. Islam holds Muhammad above God. Islam is in a desperate situation. It must prove that Muhammad was not a liar. And time is short for Satan and his one-world religion. If you're a Christian and you do not know what Islam teaches, go look for Muhammad in the Bible. It is a major thrust of Islam's Dawa of Deception. Islam must innovate references to Muhammad. And their use of Isaiah 42:13 shows just how desperate they are. Just so you know, I'm not the least bit worried what you will find. But if you happen to find even one Islamic site refuting application of Isaiah 42:13, please, 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 let me know. I have never found an Islamic site factually and honestly refuting their gross and blasphemous errors. Allow that to sink in. As you recall how active debate is in Christian circles, can you imagine any Christian sect trying to teach that prophecy of God is of the Pope, or Billy Graham, or Mother Teresa? The only such things I can imagine are the current crop of folks claiming Obama is the Antichrist. But we're talking about misappropriating prophecy about God for a man. And no, Obama is not the Antichrist. He may be a Mohammedan, but that is only a diversion. The real shame is that people in Islam are so deceived they worship Muhammad and don't even know it. Christians pray for so-called Muslims to have their eyes opened. They don't want to follow a lie to hell. That is why they are so easily controlled by Muhammad's threats of hell for not following him. Pray that God will give them courage to seek the truth and leave Islam, and be willing to die to follow the truth. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.